Hi friends, today I am going to continue this consonant sounds. In the last class I taught affricates. Today I am going to teach you fricatives. First of all, you must know the meaning of fricatives. Fricatives is a category of consonants. Already I told you, affricates, plosives, affricates, fricatives, like that. There are different categories. So among them, today I am going to deal with fricatives. What do you mean by fricatives? See, when I say if, like that, when I say like that, the teeth go and touch over the lip. So such sounds are known as fricatives. So today I shall show you the list. See here, if is there. Similarly, you is there. If we put like ak, in Tamil, like that, then we put if. So that is actually pronounced as, for if and all we use first sound, we use like that. That air is expelled through our lip. Here, uv, v, see, v. For this, v, we put the symbol v. For if symbol, first symbol, we put f. Conventional English letter, but this is phonetic symbol. For f. So wherever the sound comes, for example, Americans, you could have observed, they actually put F-O-T-O for photo, but British English, P-H-O-T-O, but P-H also gives the same sound, if. So wherever in phonetic English, wherever we come across this P-H sound, we have to put this F only. F symbol only. If. So example. Fine. 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 Wine. So here I have given two examples here. For fine, we put this if symbol and then I symbol, diphthong. And then N is the symbol for in sound and all. Similarly for wine also we put V first, the V symbol, and then we put I, A and I, that diphthong sound, and then in, that is N for in sound. So today also I am going to deal only with, I am dealing only with four symbols. Two symbols are over. Now, next we can concentrate on the other two fricatives. Tamil we don't have that light sound and strong sound. There's no difference for it. But in English, Hindi also, for Hindi they are having four id sound, D, like that. They are having lighter sound. First they'll say th, then th, and then th. Like that, there are four different sounds in this category. In English we are having two sounds, th sound and id sound, light sound, but spelling may be the same. See here, I have given examples. This it is like theta, mathematical symbol, theta. For that, I have mentioned as idvan to remember the symbol. In Tamil, we can remember as idvan and idtu, but while pronouncing, we have to like pronounce it lightly. Idtu, id, like that we have to pronounce. Example, think and this. Think and this. See, while pronouncing the word think, we are just pressing the tongue, you know, think. Whereas when you are telling this, lightly, the tongue is protruded lightly. Whereas while uttering the sound, think. Sometimes, to a certain extent, the tongue comes out. Whereas when we are pronouncing the word this, we are telling lightly, this, the tongue is even inside the teeth. So, that light sound. But swelling, for both, it starts only with TH. So, we should not have the impression whenever a word starts with the sound TH, we have to pronounce only as it. There. For there also, we put only TH. But TH is pronounced with a light this thing. We don't stress much. We pronounce it like this. There. Like that. For that only, this symbol. I showed you, this symbol for light sound. For strong sound, this symbol. So kindly remember that. So, whenever we transcribe or when we refer the dictionary, you must understand that this symbol indicates the strong sound, theta symbol, and the other one like D, slanting D, then one cross, small line in between. So that and all we have to learn the symbols by heart, so we can very easily refer again and again. Every class I am insisting that knowledge of phonetic symbols is very important. They are given in the pronunciation dictionary. In the phone itself, we can get the symbols, phonetic symbols. If you just if you type in Google also, you are getting all the symbols what I have. I am teaching step by step. So please memorize those symbols. Then only we can accurately. My daughter-in-law, she wanted to know the pronunciation of some word, some botanical word. Then she has learned these phonetic symbols, and now she has started referring from the dictionary directly, and she was thanking me. I don't mean to say that you should thank me and all. I thank God, I thank Almighty for giving me this opportunity to share some a little knowledge what I have. I want everybody to be benefiting. Please show some interest towards these phonetic symbols and learn. Thank you. Bye.